Sì. All'ambasciata americana, presto. 50 piastre se ti sbrighi. Su, facciamo la svelta, ho molta fretta.
Ehi, Malash.
Ma che fai? Ehi, dove stai andando? L'ambasciata americana è dall'altra parte.
Quanto mi avete riferito, mio caro colonnello, può sembrare incredibile.
Perché? Una specie di antiradar era già stato ideato dagli americani verso la fine dell'ultima guerra. Non si trattava, ben inteso, di un apparecchio vero e proprio, ma di qualcosa di più semplice. Temendo che i tedeschi fossero muniti di radar, gli aerei americani erano soliti inondare i cieli delle città da bombardare con una fitta pioggia di lamelle di comune stagnola. Questi foglietti ondeggiando come piccole stelle lucenti venivano segnalati dai radar nello stesso modo degli aerei.
Questa volta temo si tratti di qualcosa di diverso.
Infatti, a quanto ci consta, di un congegno elettronico capace di bloccare il funzionamento dei radar nel raggio di 500 miglia.
È sbalorditivo. Una simile distanza supera la curva terrestre.
He's dead. We do know that this Lebanese, known as Vandia, was a rather unsavory person. He never held any job for long because of his gambling debts and loose women. Obviously, when he appeared at our consulate in Geneva, because he was trying to sell us this invention, no one took him seriously.
You do now, though.
Very. We are now more than convinced that an anti-radar is operational. And I might add, the day when this Lebanese paid a visit to our consulate, all radar in the entire Geneva area suddenly stopped working completely. And it also occurred, as we told you in our report, when Vendier was murdered. Our security people called your embassy in Cairo, as we knew he had made an appointment with them. But you can see how he was found.
It's an ugly business. How long was the radar stopped this last time?
Over 12 hours. This break was responsible for the collision of two ships near Alexandria.
How were you able to know the man that was killed in Cairo was the same one who proposed the acquisition of the anti-radar in Geneva?
Fortunately, one of our agents discovered a book of his. So even without any documents, he wasn't difficult to identify. Because of this, your people in Washington have sent to Cairo one of their top agents. And we've got to send one of ours as well. This anti-radar mustn't fall into enemy hands.
Yes, sir?
Top priority for a coded message to Agent 606 in Beirut. I want him reassigned to Egypt. He must leave for Cairo right away.
Attention, please, attention. United Arab Airlines announces the arrival of flight 733 from Beirut. Passengers will be disembarking from gate 3.
Running a fever.
And the doctor hasn't arrived.
When they sent me here, I wasn't expecting to find
a woman, you were going to say. On all six missions I've done, every agent says the same thing. I thought you British cleverer than that.
Well, I'll try to do better.
But I'm afraid I wasn't told anything about you.
My countersign is 008 McDonald, and I welcome you on behalf of American Intelligence.
It's an excellent service which combines beauty and brains.
It has its advantages. All we ask is that you follow all instructions which might be received from us. And please try and forget what I am.
That surely won't be easy, but I'll try to suppress my instincts for the sake of our mission.
I don't think it's necessary to caution you on the seriousness of this operation, because I'm sure you've already been told.
McDonald, I think we have the same interests. And I'd like to add, I'm looking forward to collaborating as closely as possible with Aunt Sam.
I trust you perform as well as you talk. Watch out. Get your suitcases from the baggage room of the airport and try and get a room on my floor, the Elbourg Hotel.
I could try to manage having connecting rooms, would you mind?
I certainly would. We absolutely must avoid being seen together, if possible. I work nights at the Pearl of Sahara under the name of Piper Astor. When you want to try and contact me, all you have to do is applaud my show a little more than the other men.
So, from what I gather, I'm supposed to function as a sort of personal fan of yours.
In a certain sense, yes.
News of the anti-raider?
All I have been able to find out is that Van Deer was seen frequently in the company of a wealthy Oriental merchant by the name of Tanaki.
What else?
That's all.
That's not much.
Well, I'd say it's a lead. We know that an Oriental was seen in Geneva about the time Van Deer was there, when he was trying to make contact with your consulate. Satisfied?
Must be a tie-in. Have you found out any of his weak points yet?
He has two. He is a confirmed roulette player, as well as having a fondness for blondes.
Well, those could be the weak points of anyone. Even mine, I would say.
How weak are you?
At this point, I'm so weak that I can hardly stand up anymore. Unload my bags.
Yes,
and please tip the driver.
Yes, sir. I've loaded all the bags and put it in the room.
Good. Now take his car to the garage.
May I help you, sir?
I'd like a room overlooking the river with air conditioning and, if possible, on the fourth floor.
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. All our rooms are occupied. I just remembered. I believe 435 is vacant.
Give him suite 361. Overlooks the Nile. It's nicer. Excuse me, I'm the manager of this hotel. My name is Kemp. Have you come to Cairo for a holiday?
No, I'm preparing a paper on hieroglyphics.
Ah, interesting. I used to be an Egyptologist when I came here, but now I also manage a nightclub in town. Perhaps you can find the time to visit it, Mr.
Smith. Frank Archibald Smith.
Mr. Someone. Smith? Here is your key, sir.
Well, good day, Mr. Smith.
Good day, sir.
Faites bonjour, mesdames, messieurs. Faites bonjour.
Monsieur. Très bien, madame.
Les jeux sont faits. Rien ne va plus.
Un teint rouge impérément.
Je l'ai obtenu. Rien ne va plus.
Oui, toi, impérément.
Messieurs, dames, faites vos jeux. Faites vos jeux.
Play 36. It will bring you good fortune.
And if it doesn't...
I will give you odds of 200 to 1 that you will win.
Better for me to lose.
Rien ne va plus. 24, noir, pair et passe.
Here.
No, you mustn't do that. It's too much.
Oh, please accept, won't you? After all, I made a wager, and you have won them.
No, you were the one who made the bet, not I. But you can buy me a drink before it's a change for my next show. That is, of course, if you want to. And besides, you wouldn't have to spend all of that.
A bank.
Yes, Sahib.
to toast your beauty. Ah, you know I have watched every one of your shows since you arrived, Miss Astor.
And don't you find it tiring, since it's nearly always the same?
No, not when I enjoy watching you as well as listening. Miss Astor, don't you find this cocktail rather badly made?
I can't say that I like it too much.
If I'm not mistaken, your next show does not begin until 1. Could I invite you to my house, which is just nearby? I will give you a much better drink than this one. And perhaps you will honor me by admiring my famous collection of jade.
I always thought gentlemen kept etchings to entice girls to their apartments.
Well, yes. Although I would say that you wouldn't find a man who keeps etchings quite as interesting as one who keeps jade. Agree?
I can see that the man who collects jade is more charming.
You're kind.
A telephone call.
Yes.
They said it was urgent. Mm. Upstairs, sir. That way, sir.
I guess you do well at roulette.
Yes, I do. But I also have other interests which are more profitable. If not just as risky. What may I offer you?
A martini, thank you.
I was sure, Miss Astor, that you'd prefer a cocktail which was even stronger.
Well, only on special occasions. But why do you say that?
From your way of singing, I would say that you were explosive. You see, I have a sort of intuition. Pity that here in Cairo one cannot find records of Piper Astor. If I could hear your voice, I could probably tell you much more. Would you please excuse me for just a moment? There's something I must take care of.
Of course.
Looking for something?
Well, I was looking for the jade. I've been very curious to see it.
And it was only the jade which caused you to do everything you could to know me. What kind of a fool you take me for. I suggest you put all your cards on the table, Miss Astor. Now, what do you want here?
Show me, Miss Astor. I'm Captain Yusuf of the Egyptian police force.
Do you always wait until a woman's undressed before you present yourself?
Aggressive, able, pretty. Description fits you well. Excuse me. I wasn't trying to make fun of you, Miss McDonald. Your arrival, like that of your English colleague, was announced to our government with an urgent request for collaboration.
And did they also inform you of the urgent nature of our mission?
Naturally. And because we know what you're trying to do, you may count on our help. This anti-radar is supposed to be somewhere in our country, and we don't want it here.
You arrived at just the right time. You will find something which will be of interest to you at the house of an Oriental called Tanaki.
I know him. He was arrested twice on suspicion of smuggling, but we believe he's working for one of the big powers.
Why do you?
We found that he's taken a lot of trips to the Orient, and we've been trying to get enough proof to be able to try him.
You might be glad to know that you'll be spared that trouble. Somebody decided to do away with him. He's been murdered. I would say the state's been saved some expense. I was there, but unfortunately I didn't see who did it. He must have double-crossed somebody.
Is that all you know?
Yes, but if I find out anything else about him or the killers, I'll be sure and let you know.
I'd appreciate that. And if you should ever want to reach me, just call the political section at any time.
Oh, by the way, Captain, I forgot to tell you that my pistol is a .22 caliber, which uses Winchester supersonic.
And I'm sure you know how to use it well, Miss Astor. Oh, I forgot to tell you. I enjoyed your show very much. You were wonderful.
Stay out. I can't imagine how I've missed you and how I've waited all day for this moment. I know they're spying on us. The room is full of microphones.
Right.
Oh, darling, I hope this night never ends.
So do I, my dear. But I remember it forever.
Dovrò fare uno sforzo per ascoltarti.
They murdered the Oriental while I was there.
Who were they?
I wasn't able to see them well, but they could have been agents.
Somebody tried to throw me off a tower this evening. Interesting night. Oh, dear, tell me that you love me. I love you.
I also watched them as they were taking a man away from that villa. I was able to see him clearly before they left there. And I've seen that face before. I'm certain I've seen that face someplace. But where, Frank?
Try to remember.
È quello che sto facendo, ma tu mi distrai.
Oh, Frank, of course. Gina Lollobrigida. Oh, my sweetheart.
Yes, dear.
Oh, my darling, whoever said that the English were cold?
It was the French, they're jealous.
Ah, yes, I know now. He was in a photograph with Gina Lollobrigida. I was sure I saw him somewhere. His face was very odd. Why, he was getting off a plane.
Enough of Gina Lollobrigida. Why don't we think of us now?
Yes, miss.
back issues of Life?
Yes, on the table.
Thank you. Hello. Wait here a moment. I'll call her. Good morning. Is this the first time you've been to our institute?
Yes, the hotel gave me your ad. I'm sorry, but our cosmetic display won't be ready until this afternoon. But if there is any other of our services you would like, we are at your complete disposal.
Yes, a shampoo and a manicure.
Very well. We use a special treatment you'll like.
Would you mind if I made a phone
call? Why, no. Use that one there.
Mi dia la polizia. Sezione politica.
Subito.
Hello. Captain, you're there.
What's wrong? Operator.
Kemp has been watching me for more than an hour.
Where is he?
Behind me on the balcony.
Pick up the magazine and turn to page 73.
He's dead.
Oh, no. Frank.
We've got to get him out of there.
Cut off the current.
Avez-vous fait à la main, c'est samovar, monsieur?
Oui, madame.
Combien coûte?
Je peux vous le donner pour 15 lire.
Oh, mais c'est trop cher, 15 lire. Le posso dare 10 sterline.
Il n'est pas possible, madame.
Oh, quel dommage.
Vous parlez très bien français, mademoiselle.
Les grecs et l'espagnol.
Moi, l'allemand et l'italien. Nous faisons l'ONU à nous deux.
Merci beaucoup, monsieur. Il est trop cher. Au revoir.
Pas de quoi, madame.
Are you sure that Kemp hasn't got someone following you?
Yes. I left word not to be awakened before noon, but I managed to slip out using the service exit. Any luck?
I went to Alitalia. I found out the flight of Gina Lollobrigida was 547, Paris, Cairo, Bombay. I looked over the list of passengers who had disembarked at Cairo.
And?
I'm almost sure that our man is Hans Meintz. He lives in Zermatt.
Switzerland. It's beginning to make sense. Evidently, Kemp was competing with the Oriental for the anti-radar.
So he killed him and then kidnapped this engineer Meintz, who in all probability invented the anti-radar.
Pretty clever of you, I would say. I can see you went to Oxford.
What I want to find out is who's behind Kemp.
We'll find out before long. One thing is certain, he's worried about both of us. And what address did Meintz give while in Egypt?
He said he was staying near Luxor. He must have a villa there.
Is it far from here?
Oh, about 200 miles.
We've got to get there as soon as we can. It's the only logical place to find the anti-radar.
If we don't get there too late.
Only £10 a day for a car like that is a steal.
All right, here's another five, so you won't have me arrested.
Thank you, sir. How many did you fill the tank?
All set.
Good.
To the letter. You told us not to tail them, but only to be present every night at the girls' show and watch their hotel.
Mm-hmm.
And why do you think I had you do all that? So you can lose them if they decided to go out of town? Don't you realize that that American girl and her English partner were the only ones who could eventually lead us to the anti-radar site, or could help us uncover a whole nest of spies?
I'm sorry, sir. We're sure they couldn't have gotten very far.
Ah.
I'll catch up with them soon.
Well, you'd better. For the sake of your future, Sergeant.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir?
I want all patrol car units alerted at once. You'd better also warn the frontier guards as well. Well, what are you waiting for? Get to work! The least you can do is to find out how they left the city.
Right away, sir.
I know that we are in a big hurry, but I prefer to be shot at than be splattered all over the highway.
I agree with you, but something's wrong with the brakes.
You're not serious.
Of course I'm serious. The brakes don't work, I tell you.
Shift into low, then. Try the handbrake.
I've tried that, but nothing works.
Yes, it's beautiful. Well, I guess we better go back by bus.
No, I think we'd better try going ahead by bus, at least until we find a motel.
That's pretty optimistic of you.
Well, there's sure to be a place with a telephone somewhere nearby. Maybe we could try hitchhiking.
All right, I'm game.
But there's no room for you up front. You can ride in the back if you like.
And we'd appreciate your stopping at the first gas station you come to, wherever there's a telephone.
And thanks in advance for everything.
I'm sure you're welcome. Dancing the surf.
This section of the road must be undergoing repair. These bloody Egyptians still haven't gotten it through their heads that one has to slow down once in a while.
But I have a vague impression that it isn't a simple matter of road repair. Why, sure, this isn't the state highway. I'll bet we've changed direction.
Well, that's impossible. This is the only road.
Frank, we've been trapped. The man who's driving the truck tried to kill me yesterday. He killed the Oriental.
We've been taken in like a couple of fools.
Don't waste your ammunition. It's bulletproof.
Potremo resistere circa 10 minuti se la pressione del gas non aumenta. Dammi un fazzoletto, presto.
Yeah, this is liquid oxygen, but I don't have much. Try breathing as little as possible and slowly.
We've got to try and find some way out of here.
To be a secret agent in 10 days.
I guess I'd better read it. Come on. Oh, the motor's still running. Does your book also teach you how to drive a diesel truck? I guess it doesn't.
Ecco la statale.
Certo, è abbastanza strano che Kemp sia stato così previdente.
Che vuoi dire?
Ha fatto preparare una seconda trappola nel caso fossimo sopravvissuti alla rottura dei freni. Che ne pensi?
Kemp is both clever and capable. After he arranged to sabotage our rented car, he sent this truck after us just in case we were only wounded. It's pretty smart of him.
Very smart. Someone who could plan all of that out. Changing the gears, bleeding the brakes. He could do anything.
Well, let's try catching up with Mike now. Fortunately for us, this truck seems to have a wonderful motor inside of it. So quiet it doesn't seem a diesel.
Yes, it's so quiet it's ticking like a clock.
Just like a Rolls Royce.
But this isn't any Rolls Royce. And there's no clock in the truck.
Come on, run!
Auto in ascolto. Rintracciare una Chevrolet azzurra, targa GZ1224.
There's no telephone. What next?
Maybe you can explain to me now why you turned down that ride in the MG.
Today, if my own brother had offered us a ride, I'd have turned it down.
Почему не выбрали другую дорогу? Была гораздо короче. Абсурд.
Дорога была испорчена.
Say, where are they from?
They're Russian. Russian tourists. I'm sorry about the telephone, but we do have food and drink.
Ah! All the excitement gave me an appetite.
I guess that's a woman's reaction, but I myself get thirsty. I'd like a nice long scotch. Have you whiskey?
Whiskey? We don't have any whiskey, but we do have some good, strong cannabis milk.
It goes much better with bread and apricots. Soon it will be dawn. We better try going in now.
I think you're right. Maybe we waited too long already. Hey, this is a devil of a time to be putting on lipstick.
I was only making sure my tear gas was working all right, that's all.
Hello?
silence makes me nervous. I'd almost prefer they were shooting at us.
They probably will, don't worry. Meanwhile, we've got to go over this fence. Come, I'll give you a hand.
I guess you really meant it when you said you'd give me a hand.
Think you're doing? All right, hands up and no tricks.
You too.
Probably they'll all be on her necks now.
Yes, that's exactly it, Mr. Smith. Miss Astor is perfectly right. They're completely surrounded. Wouldn't it be better to surrender quietly? I might spare your life.
Per me guadagnerete molto di più.
Kemp, non ti aspettare la solita frase cretina. Venderemo cara la nostra pelle o roba del genere. Ma visto che la vita è l'unica cosa che abbiamo, siamo disposti a trattare.
Dipende dalle proposte.
Ebbene, eccovi la mia proposta. Per ora vi garantisco il dono più bello. La vita.
You're much too generous, Kemp.
You haven't a chance.
You might be right if I didn't have this.
Put it down. It won't help you a bit, Mr. Smith.
Prove it. I'm from Missouri.
Are you convinced now that this is the end of the line for the both of you?
You.
Better listen to the boss.
You see now that I was right. Well, boys, I'll leave the messy details up to Ali. Kill them.
This time you won't get away from us. By the time we finish, there won't be a trace of you left.
Come on.
through. But most likely you'll be dead before I get back, and I won't have to bother looking at your pretty face again. Now the blonde and me are going to have a little party.
Until we get back, keep your eyes on him.
Make you regret that. Hey, put his pistol on it. Do you recognize this? Girl, the rays from the oven will turn you into powder. They're the rays that neutralize the anti-radar. This is what will happen to you and your girl.
Detto che sparirai per sempre dalla faccia della terra.
Wake up, you pig. I'll be back to settle our account. That TV cable. It should lead us to camp. Camp's gotten away. He's made fools of both of us.
And we haven't even got a clue as to where he might be heading.
troppo tardi.
Quella canaglia di Kemp non ha voluto lasciare tracce.
Non c'è altro da fare. Ci conviene distruggere tutte le attrezzature esistenti nella villa.
Probabilmente il dispositivo centrale dell'antiradar è installato sulla terrazza. Andiamo a dare un'occhiata.
Oh, here you are. Who is that, one of Kemp's men?
That's Engineer Mark. He invented the anti-radar.
There was a man with a black glove who was part of the gang. Did he get away? No, don't worry. We've got him. He's downstairs. Cyanide.
Look, this must be the control panel for the whole anti-radar network.
And there's the radar. It must be a pilot model.
Io non conosco gli schemi dei campi elettromagnetici, ma è chiaro che l'antiradar emette le sue interferenze mediante questi congegni. Bisogna distruggere gli apparecchi.
We'd better destroy this apparatus at once.
Fix it. It won't work anymore now.
The anti-radar has been destroyed, but we haven't finished our mission yet.
Why not?
Mines must have hidden the plans to his invention someplace. And those plans exist. If Kemp or anyone else gets a hold of them, we run the risk that more of these machines will show up somewhere else in the world.
Non fare il furbo. Nessuno potrà cavarti dagli impicci. Se invece parli, vedrò di aiutarti.
Già, con lo sgabello. Un calcio sotto i piedi e quando penderò dalla corda mi avrete aiutato a crepare.
The trap. You'll probably give the rope a couple of ex...
That's...
How am I supposed to defend myself? Look, I was only working for Kemp. He gave all the orders. I didn't kill anyone.
Then what was this for? Skin diving?
It was only used to defend myself against...
The Oriental. He was killed by a knife from the same weapon you have. And I'm quite sure that you were the one who killed the...
No, that was Tanaki. Because Van Deer owed the Oriental a small fortune and said he'd pay him off when his big deal went through. But the Oriental was smart and got him to talk.
Vai avanti.
Van Deer ignorava che Tanaka fosse una spia al servizio della Cina e fu tolto di mezzo mentre tentava di vendere l'antiradar agli americani.
And Kemp, where does he fit in the whole plan of things?
Kemp was told about the invention by a technician who worked for mines.
We know the rest of the story. Now, where are the plans hidden for the construction of the anti-radar sites?
I don't know. I told you everything.
Captain, we've got to go and find those plans.
I'll drive you, but I want this house searched thoroughly.
Arriveremo a Zurigo fra circa 50 minuti, poi ci vorranno un paio d'ore di macchine.
Te l'ho già detto, la nostra missione non finirà che a Zermatt.
Pensi davvero che troveremo i piani? Mainz potrebbe averli distrutti.
Non credo. Nessun inventore agirebbe così.
Allora non ci resta che mettere a soqquadro la Svizzera.
Non è necessario. Basta scoprire dove ha abitato Mainz fino a pochi mesi fa.
A proposito, McDonald, non credi che sarà meglio spacciarsi per marito e moglie? Per favore.
Prego.
A scotch for me and an orange juice for my wife.
Yes, sir, right away, sir.
like a nice double room, please.
Welcome to Chairman. Have you made reservations?
No, we're on our honeymoon and we forgot to write ahead.
I see. Room 222, second floor. It has a very fine view of the Matterhorn. Napoleon once slept there before this became an hotel.
Pity it wasn't Nelson. By the way, you certainly know a Professor Hans Mainz who's been living here in Zermatt.
Why, of course. Everyone here in Zermatt knows Professor Mainz.
Yes. Then you know him.
No, I don't know him. But I do know he lives around here. Perhaps our Burgermeister might be able to furnish us with some definite information about him.
Hallo? Bitte verbinden Sie mich mit dem Rathaus. Danke. Hallo? Ist Herr Schumann da? Hier ist Hotel Walterhof. Ja, wenn er wiederkommt, würden Sie ihn bitten, den Portier anzurufen.
I'm sorry, but the Herr Burgermeister is out for the moment. He will call here as soon as he returns.
Thank you, my dear.
Matto.
Sette andrai da me, rimpiangerai le notti d'amore, ricorderai per sempre i miei baci, quei baci che adesso non vuoi. Se te mandrai da me, ricorderai le cose.
Behave now, Frank.
But I'm just playing the good husband.
I want you to, but there are certain things one should do in private.
Is that a promise?
I didn't think I had to. Have you forgotten we'll have the whole night together?
MacDonald, are you not forgetting our mission?
Why, it's all part of our mission.
My dear, I wonder what Uncle Sam will say.
Mm.
Telephone call for you.
Excuse me. Around 300 yards from the ski lift on top of a mountain. The Burgermeister says he only stayed there a short time before he went to Egypt.
Does anyone live there now?
No, we can get in whenever we want to. Of course, I told the Burgermeister that we were friends of his and wanted to say hello to the professor. As you can see, I was following your orders, my dear.
Hear me, Frank? I'm right next to you. I'd like to tell you something.
Yes.
You're very sweet.
You're sweet too, but I'm so tired.
Ya tibia, you blue.
I love you too.
Last night you passed right out on me. Besides, you didn't seem to be drinking very much.
It's the change in altitude and climate after being in That should be his place.
It's the only one up here, and there seems to be no one there. I think we're getting warm. Well, come on. I think we've hit the bullseye. Mines must have developed it here. And I'm sure the plans are somewhere in the house. Frank, while I'm looking in here, why don't you search the other rooms? We'll finish sooner that way.
Right you are. Oh, a bit of all right. Pity there's nobody but us around to enjoy the place.
Oh, well, almost nobody.
But I remember her.
Well, she was the one who was running that beauty shop in Cairo. Then if she's here, that means that Kim...
must be here, too. You weren't expecting me, were you? Hold it. One move and it'll be my pleasure to kill you.
You are a very unpredictable man, Kemp. Tell me one thing, however. How were you able to get here before us?
I was too smart for you, huh? Why, I've had those plans for over a week. That's why I killed Professor Mines. I knew you'd try to get them. I've been watching you since you arrived and followed you here. Now I'm going to finish what I started in Luxor.
Before that, Kemp, would you mind telling us one thing? Which power are you working for?
I work for Kemp. Why should I be satisfied with crumbs when I can have it all? And with those plans, the world will be mine. I'll play one country against the other.
That's a pretty risky game.
For you. But I have what it takes. One needs intelligence. One move and it'll be my pleasure to kill you.
Now hold on, old chap. I had a proposition that I thought might interest you.
What's that?
I thought maybe you and I could make a deal.
What for? I don't need anybody.
Party's over. As you see, it's bulletproof.
No wonder you were overweight on the plane. They must be in the briefcase. The lock is stuck.
Now, really, don't you ever give up?
Oh, here are the plans at last.
Over here. I think
someone's coming. We better hurry.
Coming from in there.
I guess what you heard were the champagne corks. We're celebrating.
Well, it certainly wasn't flat. Come on, fellas.
Hey,
I guess everyone is having lunch by this time.
And we are lucky enough to have this ski lift all to ourselves. Just the two of us. You know, Mac, I have a little surprise just for you.
Really?
All right, young lady. You better give me those plans.
No, my dear, I'm not going to give them to you.
Then you're going to force me to shoot you. The same way I killed the real agent 606 in Beirut the night before he was leaving for Cairo. I'm agent Z44 of the Soviet Secret Service.
I'm sorry to disappoint you, but I already knew that. I've been wise to you for some time. And so last night, comrade, I unloaded your pistol. Make a move and I'll kill you.
But how did you find out?
I became suspicious of you when we copped that MG. You made me take the road to the right, saying the other road was closed. You had to hear that from those Russians. They were the only ones at the Oasis. But I had to check and make absolutely sure I wasn't wrong about you. So last night I put a little pill in your whiskey. It produces a sort of hypnosis. And so when you were in that state, it was very easy for me to get you to talk.
Impossible. I would have answered you in English.
That's true if I'd questioned you only in English. But I added the only phrase I knew in Russian. I love you. And you, Ivanov, understood me very well.
I have to confess, I never thought you were so clever.
And there was another error of yours, I might add. When you considered that our mission was over in Cairo without bothering about the plans. Oh, it was obvious that you wanted me out of your way then, so you might find them yourself.
That pistol holds only two bullets, and one you used on Kent. Do you think you might miss with the other one?
I shouldn't try. And I have a surprise of my own. This little gadget is, oh, so clever. While we're talking, it's sending all that we say to my colleagues. They'll be waiting for us when we get off. Do you read us, fellas?
MacDonald, we read you just fine. We're down here waiting and passing as tourists.
Play it cool, girl. We'll meet you when you get off.
Well, you've won.
Well, Jack.
Hello, Jack.
Good to see you, Mac.
Hello, Jack. Well, I'm sure glad this is over. Here are the plans to the anti-radar.
Wonderful.
We think the climate is too warm for you here, Tovarich Ivanovich. We're sure that you will find in Siberia the temperature is much better for you. Come along.
Poor guy, I think I'd better send him a good wool sweater.
You got out of that one, Mac. If you hadn't gotten that last pin, you'd have had to marry me. That was our bet.
Well, we wouldn't have had much of a honeymoon. My leave is up tomorrow. Well, fellas, after 2 months' vacation, I'm afraid they're putting me back to work.
Oh, wait a minute, doll. I want you to meet Major Smith, the British military attaché. He's been waiting to play a game with you. Major Smith, here's our star player.
So I just broke 100. Pretty bad.
Hello, MacDonald.
Well, hello, Major. I'm told you're stationed in Leningrad.
Yes, I flew in from there this morning.
And do you find it colder in Leningrad or in Siberia?
Well, you'll be glad to know that I'm really working for the British after all.
Oh, Frank. Are you ready, Major? Shall we get started on our new match?
You mean on our mission, MacDonald? On our next mission.